The first part of our Project Zambia immersion trip in 2015 took us to Kobada Orphanage, an orphanage Project Zambia has been working in since 2002.
This is Kobada Orphanage, the very first project that Project Zambia visited back in 2002. It's a project we've been involved in ever since. It's run by a wonderful woman called Angela Mianda. Angela's transformed the lives of more than 500 children who've been through this orphanage. Many of them have gone on to university and on to a better future.
So today's our first full day back in Zambia. We got up and got ready this morning and we're going to visit all the sites. So we're just back in Kobada Orphanage and we've got to talk to some of the girls that I was friendly with last year, Imelda and Memory. Okay. And then we've just sat and played with some of the younger kids, which has been great.
At the moment, currently there's approximately 70 children in the orphanage, and they've all got their own little jobs, as you can see in the background here. There's a wonderful garden here, and they help to grow plants, which are then sold on. It's kind of an income-generating project to help supplement, to help pay for some of the costs of other places.
The next part of our immersion journey took us into the Zeese compound. The compound is home to over 100,000 people, most of whom live under $1 a day.
We're here in the Zeese compound, and we've just on a bit of a tour around the compound. Mr. Dixon from St. Catherine's School, the head teacher, has very kindly brought us around. We've just stopped here at the dam, as you can see behind me. It's full of rubbish, and there's bits of playing in it and all the rest of it. One of the things that you'll not be able to see, which is actually the smell of it. The smell is just atrocious, and it's one of the things actually that is occurring around the whole compound, is the smell. We walked through it, and to be honest with you, the conditions, they really are terrible.
The people of Massis, whose homes are built on top of a rubbish dump, are amongst the poorest of the poor. But central to Project Zambia's philosophy is that education is the key to eradicating poverty. That's why over the past 10 years we have been working in St. Catherine's School, where 30 children gaining an education has grown to 300. While there our volunteers help to brighten the school up a bit.
We're in Mrs. Parkland and we're just painting the gate here at St. Catherine's. For the past couple of days. As you can see, we've put some of the Zambia colours into it, and then we have the idea of the sun to symbolise light and hope for the children here in Massis.
Okay, this is the school hall, school and community hall for Massis. We started building this about 3 weeks ago. When I left here 2 weeks ago, it was just simply at two grease block level. You can see since we've left, it's now come up, heading towards roof level now. The ambition is that this will become a centre for all celebration and meetings in Massis. It'll function duly as a school hall with the one entrance on this side, and on the bottom side, there'll be for weddings and for groups to come here. We're also hoping to landscape this area here, down here, and to make it like a garden. Because we're thinking that people are going to be using it for celebrations and things, that they want to have a nice backdrop, want to make it something completely different. So that's something we're looking at over the next while.
By the time our volunteers were ready to leave Lusaka around 2 weeks later, all was nearly done. All that was left to do was to put on the roof and add some finishing touches. From Massis, our volunteers made the short trip across the railway lines to the St. Lawrence Home of Hope. This summer, Project Zambia helped to transform the Home of Hope into an oasis for the children who live there. The Home of Hope is a centre for street children, where Brother Isaac and his team give the children food, shelter, education, and most importantly, love. There they help to rehabilitate the boys so they can go back to their families and provide a nurturing environment for those who cannot return home. From Lusaka, our volunteers took the 8-hour bus journey to Mongu, the capital of Western Province, to visit a feeding programme Project Zambia has funded for the last 6 years. Our volunteers met with the recipients of the feeding programme, grandparents looking after their grandchildren.
Yo.
William, well, very good. Says you decided to give them food, to give the people like herself food, without even knowing her. Mm-hmm. It's only God who knows.
In Mongu, we met with Brother John McCord. Brother John brings the food to these people on a weekly basis.
I was delighted to welcome some of the members of the PZ from Belfast out to us, and they have been supporting our food programme for the last 7-8 years, and I was delighted to be able to bring these people out to show them and to meet the people whom they are supporting. And these are people elderly, blind, crippled, lame, and they're not able to fend for themselves, they're not able to do anything for themselves, in fact. And they learned yesterday, I think, my young friends from PZ, how important and how valuable their contribution is to the lives of these people, because they have made a difference to them.